Good day again, this is Mr. Matebula. I'm back again, It's a great honor that God has granted us an opportunity to be seeing this day, that is a power that God has given us in order for us to proclaim His gospel, in order for us to complete our mission here on earth, because we mustn't depart here on earth without completing our mission, which God has called us to do. So yeah, for those whom this are first time watching this video, welcome to this channel where the word of God has been shared to people, the people of God, not just only the people of God, but the people want a good direction, because we specialize by telling the good direction. There are different directions here on earth, but we specialize in telling about the good direction, which is the direction of God, and we are confident about this direction of God. He is our God. So first of all, I would like to thank God for granting us an opportunity to be standing here, to be in this platform, sharing the word of God, sharing the word of God to the people out there, sharing the word of God. So it's a great honor that God has granted us an opportunity to be standing, to be preaching his gospel. So without wasting any time, our message for today is about confidence. Our message for today is about confidence. It's about confidence. So under this topic of confidence, we have five scriptures. Our first scripture, please note out there, our first scripture, we have Psalm 118 verse 8 to 9. Psalm 118 verse 8 to 9. Our second scripture is Jeremiah 17 verse 7. Our third scripture is First Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 8. First Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 8. Our fourth scripture is Hebrews chapter 6 verse 18. Is Hebrews chapter 6 verse 18. Then our last but not least scripture is First John chapter 5 verse number 14. So let us begin with our today's message. Let us open our Bible from the first verse which I have told you to note out there. Let us open our Bible and hear what the book of God, what the good news, what the Bible have for us regarding this topic of confidence. And I believe and have a feeling that we are going to receive a clear insight about this thing of confidence. Let us open our Bible, our first scripture, which is Psalm 118 verse number 8 to 9. Psalm 118 verse 8 to 9. Psalm 118 verse 8 to 9. So it reads as follows. Verse 8 to 9. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than trust in humans. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than trust in princes. What a powerful two verses. They say that it is powerful. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in human. Trusting in human, it's risk. It's a risk. Trusting in humans, it's a risk, because we as human beings will promise you something today, then tomorrow our promise won't be fulfilled. We will be telling you about excuses why we are not able to complete those promises that we promised you yesterday or the previous days. So people, putting our confidence in people, it is a risk. Putting our confidence on material things, it's a risk. Putting our confidence in our degree, putting our confidence to our tangible, on our tangible things, it's a risk, because those things, they don't last, but only God lasts. Why I'm saying so? It is because our God is eternal, and those things are not eternal. Those things are human made. Everything that is human made, it does not have what? It does not have quality. But everything that comes from God, it has what? It has quality. Putting our trust on education, it's vanity. Putting our trust on our labor or job or jobs, it's vanity, because tomorrow you will wake up receiving a call from your boss or from your manager telling you that you are dismissed without even being involved in bad activities or bad act regarding your boss when he expel you from your work. So putting our trust on things which are tangible, it's a risk. We have to put our trust in God. We have to trust in God. By trusting in God, we are safe. Putting our trust on our parents, it is a risk, because tomorrow we will wake up our parents. We will wake up finding our parent dead. Properties that we have, it's vanity, because those things, they don't have what? They don't have quality. It is risk for us for putting trust in the things of this world, because things, putting our trust, putting our confidence in the things of this world, that what leads to depression. Putting our trust on the things of this world, that's what brings destruction to us. So we must first do what? We must first put our trust in God, we will put our trust on the things of this world after putting our trust in God, because putting our confidence on the things of this world without putting our confidence on God first, it is risky, because if those things disappoint us, we will no longer have a thing to hold on. But if we put our trust on God, remember, as I've told you in the beginning, that God never disappoints us. So we have to put our trust in God. We have to put our confidence in God, because He is our God. He is our God. He never disappoints us. He never disappoints us. So we have to put our trust in God first. We have to put our confidence first on the things of this world. We have to put our trust on God first, then the things of this world will do what? Will follow. Hallelujah out there. Let us navigate to our second scripture, which is Jeremiah 17, verse number 7. Jeremiah 17, it reads as follows. Read Jeremiah 17, it reads as follows, my people out there. Jeremiah 17:7. But blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence is in Him. Just a revision of what we have just spoken about in the first scripture that we have read in the beginning, which was Psalm 108. So we have to put our trust in God. That's our message for today. We have to, our confidence must be first rooted in God. Then it will be secondly rooted on the things of this world. Because by swapping our confidence, by putting our confidence first on the things of this world, then putting our confidence on God secondly, that will destroy us within. That's why we find most of the people being depressed, suicidal. Why? Because they've chosen to neglect God by doing what? By replacing him, by putting him as a second priority. While they're prioritizing what? While they're prioritizing the things of this world. While they're prioritizing their wealth, their intellect, their beautiful children, their wives, their everything that they have which is tangible. So it is risk for us to put our trust in the things of this world. Because it leads to what? It leads to depression. It leads to depression. Most of the people become suicidal because they feel like they have lost their hope after they have lost all of those things which are tangible that they have lost. So it is important for us out there to put our trust, to put our confidence in God, because he never disappoints us. He never disappoints us. He is faithful and just. He is faithful and just to accept our confidence. Hallelujah out there. So let us navigate to our second scripture. To our third, not second scripture, which is Hebrew. Or which is 1 Thessalonians 5:8. It's 1 Thessalonians 5:8. 1 Thessalonians verse 5 number 8 about confidence. 1 Thessalonians verse 5 to 8. Oh, 1 Thessalonians verse 5, chapter 5 verse 8. Chapter 5 verse 8. It reads as follows. But since we belong to the day, let us be sober, putting on faith and love as a breastplate and the hope of salvation as a helmet. Let us read it again. But since we belong to the day, let us be sober, putting on faith and love as a breastplate and hope of salvation as a helmet. We have to put first what? We have to be sober and put faith and love as a breastplate of our, as a breastplate and hope as a helmet of our, as a helmet of our salvation. Hope as a helmet of our salvation. So hope act as what? Hope act as a helmet of our salvation. Because where hope is, our salvation is covered by hope. Hallelujah out there. So we have to be sober. We have to be sober by being sober and putting what? Love, faith, and what? Putting faith, love as a breastplate. Putting faith and love. We have to have love out there. Love is one of the, it's a center. It's a center of Christianity. The center of Christianity. We specialize in love here in Christianity. So we have love. There is love in here because we are first loved by God. We are first loved by God. So we have to be sober out there, putting faith and love as what? As a breastplate. As a breastplate. As a breastplate. So, and what? And hope as a helmet of our what? As a helmet of our salvation. It's very important out there. It's very important out there to be confident in this God, which is our God. Our God who created heavens and earth, who created heavens and earth without any assistance. That's why I love this God. That's why I love this God, because he does not want to be assisted. He do his things without being assisted, because he has power. He have power. Our God have power to move mountains. Our God have power to move challenges that we face away from us. Our God have power to give us ability or strength to pass through the difficulties of this world. Hallelujah. Out there. Let us go to our third scripture, or to our fourth scripture, which is Hebrews 6 verse 18. Hebrews 6 verse 18. Hebrews 6 verse 18. It reads as follows. God did this so that, or 6 verse 18. The subtitle of the message is the certainty of God's promise. The certainty of God's promise. It reads as follows. God did this so that by the two unchangeable things in which it is impossible for God to lie, we who have fled to take hold of the hope set before us may be greatly encouraged. Hallelujah, out there. So it is impossible for God to lie. God won't lie. He will not lie. He won't lie. Our God won't lie. Our God is always faithful. Our God is always loyal. He specializes in loyalty. He's always honest to us. He's always loyal. Because look, if he wasn't loyal every day, if he wasn't loyal, there will be a day where there will be no sun. Yeah, there will be no day. There will be a day where there will be no sun. But because of he is faithful to us, every day, each and every day, there are sun rays, and there is sunset. Hallelujah, out there. So he is faithful. He has kept what? He has kept his promises to us. He has kept his promises to us. There are seasons. There are seasons which occur here on earth. We have what? There are seasons which occur here on earth. We have summer, we have autumn. We have spring, you name them. We have winter. They occur in a sequential way. In a sequential way, each and every year. Because our God is what? Our God is faithful. Our God has kept what? Has kept his promises That's why I'm saying what? That's why I'm saying we must keep our promise. We must face, we must put our confidence in Him, because by putting our confidence in Him, we are safe. By putting our confidence in Him, even if money does not allow us to, even if our present situation does not allow us to, does not allow us, but by putting our confidence in Him, we know that He allows everything which is positive to us to happen. Hallelujah out there. So let us go to our last scripture, which is John, 1 John 5 verse 14. 1 John 5 verse 14. Our subtitle, the subtitle of the message is Concluding Affirmations. Concluding Affirmations. It reads as follows. Is it? Yes, it is. 1 John chapter 5 verse 14. This is the confidence we have in approaching God, that if we ask anything according to His will, He hears us. Hallelujah out there. So, this is the confidence that we know in Him, that we have in Him. When we approach Him by asking Him everything according to His will, we know that our prayers will be answered. By asking Him according to His will, because it is very important out there. That's why salvation, it is very important for us to be saved first, to be saved first in order to accept, or to accept God first as our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, to do what? To know everything that He wants from us, for Him to activate His desire within us, for Him to be within us, in order for us to know what it is good for us, what it is good for us, and what it is not good for us. So it is very important out there, my brothers and sisters, my brethren, it is very important to know the will of God. Know the will of God for us to approach Him. For us to approach Him, praying for everything according to His will. Not just everything, but everything according to His will. According to His will, which is suitable for us, which is suitable for our health, which is suitable for our lives, which is suitable for our salvation. Hallelujah out there. So we have to be confident people first in God. We have to also be confident with the bodies that God has given us. We have to be confident with the body that God gave us, because some are not confident with their bodies that God has given them. You have to be confident with your body. You have to be confident with your parents that God has given you. You have to be confident with your siblings that God has given you. You have to be confident with the job that God has given you. But remember, first you have to be confident. Our confidence must first start in God. We have to be confident first in God. Then those things shall follow. Hallelujah. Then our confidence will be then added to those things. So we have to be confident in God first. Being confident in God first in order for us to be saved. Because it is a desire of every being to be saved here on earth. So in order for us to be saved, we have to apply the safest method, which is this method of doing what? Which is the method of accepting God, which is the method of approaching God with confidence. Hallelujah out there. So, our God, He is powerful. He is powerful, our God. You can change every situation that you are in. He can heal our hearts. He is our doctor. He is our healer. He is our sovereign God. God bless you out there. God bless you out there, my sister. God bless you out there, my brethren. God bless you out there.